Fireflies, frogs, jellyfish, mushrooms, and even parrots have mad glowing skills. Humans may rule the natural world, but we seriously miss the boat when it comes to emitting light from our own bodies. So how do these creatures do it? So the first thing you need to know is that there are two ways to get your glow on. There's bioluminescence, what these fireflies are doing, and fluorescence, which is what's going on with these parrots. Many people conflate bioluminescence and fluorescence, but you guessed it, there's a difference. Let's start with fluorescence, which also happens to be this recently discovered South American tree frog's party trick. In full sunlight, the frog appears yellow, but in twilight, the amphibian's fluorescence steps up its game, making the creature appear an eerie lime green. To fluoresce, the frog, and any other fluorescing creature, just needs two things: a molecule with excitable electrons and the right wavelength of incoming light. For excitable molecules, the frogs rely on chemicals called hyaloids, which reside in the animal's skin and glands. Incoming light excites the molecule's electrons, and as those electrons settle back down, the molecules release some light of their own. Nobody knows yet why the frog fluoresces, but it's probably to communicate a message, perhaps a little fluorescent flirtation for froggy paramours. In any case, scientists were pretty stoked to find a fluorescent tree frog. Fluorescence is rare in land animals. It's more often found in sea creatures such as turtles and fish. Of course, there's some notable exceptions of natural fluorescence on land, such as these scorpions and parrots. My favorite example of natural fluorescence happens to be the blue light emitted by nematode worms as they die. Full disclosure, I am not a huge fan of worms. I have found them terrifying since I was wee, so it doesn't surprise me that they may have a creepy death ceremony. The worms fluoresce blue thanks to a glycosylated anthranilic acid pigment that absorbs light and then emits blue wavelengths. The death glow begins in the worm's gut and spreads to the whole body as the creature wends its way to the wormy afterlife. The scientists who discovered this macabre fluorescence are using it to better understand the process of death. And that shines some light onto why scientists are so into glowing animals in general. Studying these creatures, whether they fluoresce or bioluminesce, has helped advance biology, medicine, imaging, and sensor technologies. So what about the other variety of animal glow? So bioluminescence requires oxygen and some fancy chemical equipment. What's amazing is that this chemical equipment is remarkably similar in most organisms that bioluminesce. Think fireflies, jellyfish, bacteria, and even this mushroom from Brazil, whose glowing skills were recently discovered. To emit light through bioluminescence, you need a molecule called luciferase, and you need an enzyme called luciferase. Luciferase takes oxygen and plops it onto the luciferin. The outcome is a molecule called oxyluciferin, whose electrons are in an excited state. When the electrons in oxyluciferin calm back down, they release light, which makes the organism glow. To recap, in both fluorescence and bioluminescence, light is emitted when an excited molecule's electrons calm down. The major difference between the two is that with fluorescence, you also need to start with a little bit of light to emit light. With bioluminescence, you need oxygen, an enzyme, and some nifty chemistry to glow. And some creatures have the enviable ability to do both. Probably the most famous of these glowers is the jellyfish Aquaria victoria. This sea creature uses bioluminescence to produce a faint blue light. Some of that light can then be used to excite a green fluorescent protein, better known as GFP, in the jellyfish. Sound familiar? Research on the molecule garnered Roger C&EN, Osamu Shimomura, and Martin Chalfie the 2008 Nobel Prize in Chemistry. GFP has become one of science's most valuable proteins for exploring biology and biochemistry. It's also been used to make all kinds of animals glow green. So maybe there's still hope for those humans who want to hack in a bit of glow. Personally, I might stick with my glow sticks. What's your favorite glowing creature? Tell us about it in the comments.